Greetings and peace as we come to the closing worship for the 2021 annual gathering of the Council for Health and Human Service Ministries of the United Church of Christ. I'm George Graham, and I have the privilege of serving as Vice President of Chisholm. I hope that you've been inspired by the past 3 days of the annual gathering and that you can take some sense of together and hope that you have experienced to wherever ministry and life take you. If you've enjoyed the annual gathering, I invite you to consider making a gift, if you are able and haven't already done so, to support either our Legacy Fund for Leadership Development or our Racial Equity and Inclusion Fund, which supports organizations involved directly in racial equity work. You can make a gift by going to www.chisholm.org/give, and we'll put that link in the chat. It is fitting that we close our time together in worship to be sent forth with a word of hope. To bring us that word, we welcome the Reverend Dr. Yvonne Delk, longtime justice leader in the UCC and friend of Chisholm, and Amanda Powell, who will lead us in music. God be with you. Let us prepare our hearts for worship.
Welcome back to worship. We will come in with joy in the Spirit. Also sing, try it again, gracious Spirit, heed our pleading, fashion us all anew. It's your leading that we're needing. Help us to follow you. Come, Holy Spirit, come. Come to teach us, come to nourish all who believe in Christ. Bless the faithful, may they flourish, strengthened by grace unpriced. Come, Holy Spirit, come. Come and stir us. Come and heal us. Open our eyes, we pray. Light our fire for the mission we have been called by grace. Come, Holy Spirit, come. And we'll close our time together today with singing a song written by the many. We stand with love. So I want to introduce you to the refrain of the song so that you can be ready for it when we stand together with love at the end of our time of worship. Of all of us standing together with love. Hearts and minds now to worship our holy God.
Please join us in a moment of prayer. O God of liberation, repairer of breaches, who plants gardens in the ruins of our souls, may we unearth your presence from the soil of our scattered minds.
And call upon you to awaken us to the sacredness of this moment. And every moment.
You who transforms a heart of flesh out of age-old stone.
Help us to embody this space of shared worship.
Beloveds, let us come together in hope.
In the hope that hovers over the waters of creation and flows across the ends of the earth.
That calms the roaring of the seas and the tumult of the people. Come, let us worship from this place of creation, of connection.
And find ourselves embraced by the cosmos. Amen.
As we begin our worship together, I invite you to take a moment to simply feel yourself breathing, to feel yourself alive. As you breathe deeply at your own pace, affirm that it is safe to be in your body, to be present here and now. And although we may be physically apart, see if you can sense this beloved community breathing with you across this virtual space. And sense, if you can, how the divine is also breathing with you, right here and now. And if you can't, that's okay. Know that this community will hold the hope of this truth for you, welcoming you just as you are. May the inhale and exhale of God's Spirit surround you, blessing your space with resurrection energy. Come, let us hear God's word from this place. Let us open ourselves to the presence of the great wind as she moves within and around us. Amen.
I greet you in the name of the one who is the author and finisher of our faith, the God of hope. I greet you with the word from the book of Romans 15:13. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, so that you will abound in hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. And I also greet you with the theme of the conference, that we who are the people of God, filled with the Spirit of God, that we can witness together in hope. Pray with me. Have your way with us, God, have your way. Lead us and guide us in this time of racism and sexism and classism, this time of brokenness and division, fear and hate, this time of privilege and power and pain. We have not gathered to just say the right words when our actions continue to support the status quo. We've been called for a time such as this. We have come for a face-to-face encounter with you, God, and a face-to-face encounter with one another. We want to be real as we seek the path that leads to hope. So we ask that you will open our eyes that we can see the glimpses of truth you have for us. Place in our hands the wonderful key that can unlock and set us free. Silently now, God, we wait for thee. Ready, our God, your will to see. We come surrendering everything to you, the author, the defender, and sustainer of our hope. Amen. Well, I hope that this conference has been a blessing to you. And while we may not all be abounding in hope, I really hope that we have been inspired, or you have been inspired and equipped by something that you've heard. This is an urgent time right now, and it's a very needy time in terms of feeling that the misery index is high. Our ministries are really needed. There's great pain and suffering and anxiety in the land. The pandemics of COVID-19 resulting in way over a million deaths worldwide, 400 years of racial injustice, crippling poverty, the abuse of civic and human rights. They've all unearthed the death rattle of what I'm calling empire rule of powers and principalities. And the mission and vision of the Council for Health and Human Services will require hope that is made visible through our many networks of ministry. A hope that is struggling to break through the powers and principalities of injustice that is deeply entrenched in our land. I think we're living in a time of reinvented empire. Ephesians 6:12 defines empire when it states that we're not just wrestling against flesh and blood, but we're wrestling against powers and principalities, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. So empire represents the powers and principalities and the systemic injustices that are present in our time, our nation, our communities, in our globe. They are the agents of death and destruction and division. They are the God of empire is profit and power and greed and materialism. The marks of empire are hierarchy, exclusion, domination, exploitation. And the world of the empire embraces racism and sexism and classism and homophobia. In the empire, men are exalted over women, the privileged are blessed, the poor excluded, the powerful are protected well, and the powerless dehumanized. And often prayer is just used to bless and sanctify the status quo. The very words of our focus scripture affirming God is hope and calling for a newly evolving church of Rome was calling Rome to abound in hope. But that word written by Apostle Paul was written in the midst of empire history. This church in Rome is located in the very capital of the Roman Empire. The emperor rules. All who are within its boundaries are subjects of the emperor, and life does not matter. Life is simply a statistic. Life is just a number that can be used, abused, exploited, and then tossed away. Life is defined and controlled and dominated by the emperor. But these early believers represented an alternative worldview. This is a movement of the spirit created with the authority of the Spirit of God. And this movement exists in the presence of the powers of injustice. And for this early church, spirit and witness are connected. Risk and fellowship are connected. And this is a radically inclusive movement, breaking down walls, proclaiming boldly that all life matters. This movement shares everything together, sharing all their worldly belongings together, proclaiming over and over again, life matters, male and female, Jew and Gentile, slave and free. And to speak of hope and to abound in hope was a commitment to boldly proclaim the good news before the thrones of power. So to speak of hope in this annual gathering is about more than putting our finger in the air to see which way the wind is blowing. Our journey to hope leads us to places where people are struggling for meaning, for life, for dignity, for justice. And hope makes itself known in the struggle for justice and freedom and equity. Our word made flesh is not defined simply by the meek and mild Jesus calling us to hold hands and sing kumbaya. It's the world revealed by the one who goes back home to his ministry setting, boldly proclaiming that he has been called from the vocation of carpentry to the vocation of liberation. And the ritual takes place in his home church where he affirms who he is and whose he is. He's Mary and Joseph's son, the only begotten son of God. And in his affirmation speech, he declares that the Spirit of God is upon him, anointing him to bring good news to the poor, healing for the brokenhearted, liberty to the captives, and freedom for those who are bound. Well, as we prepare to leave this annual meeting as your closing preacher, I ask, what is the word that you're taking on? What is the word in your flesh, in your spirit, in your heart, in your ministry setting? The theme, together in hope, requires that we declare who we are in ways that we are not free to walk away from. It defines who we are and announces that which will have binding authority for what we believe we are called to do. Hope will become visible because of the deliberate decision that we make to act and speak with boldness for the world that God intends. It's going back to our ministry settings and just like Jesus, declaring that God's Spirit is upon us, anointing us, empowering us through the work of our member organizations, our affiliate ministries, to bring the good news of health and healing and wholeness and humanity into being. COVID-19, systemic racism, economic disparities are at work each and every day, and they reveal and unearth the faces of empire death, empire discrimination, empire division. And there's hope. Hope is waiting to be recognized in those places where injustice reigns. Hope is waiting in those places where hate has dislodged love and mutual respect. Hope is waiting in those places where persons are reaching out of death for life. Hope is waiting in those places where fear has replaced courage and boldness. So for this preacher, the theme together in hope has to be more than a slogan. It's got to be more than a theme. Hope must become visible. So I offer the following affirmations. Hope is made visible as we claim our identity and our freedom as the people of God. Hope is made visible as we denounce empire by engaging in truth-telling and truth-facing. Hope is made visible as we invest our resources with clarity, with courage, and with conviction for justice. Well, we are the people of God. And this God is the author, the defender, and the sustainer of hope. Yahweh is defined first and foremost by divine freedom and not by the fate of any particular culture or nation. The God of hope is the one who breaks through silence with speech that sets people and nations free. The God of hope is the one who transcends the rules of authority by casting lots with those with no standing, no power, no influence in the world. This God is defined by freely offered compassion to those who, by the world's definition, are the helpless, the oppressed, and the dispossessed. And the freedom of God is asserted over and over again in the biblical tradition. But freedom alone could result in an aloof, uncaring God. The covenantal text instead portrays a God who uses freedom to become vulnerable to human experience. God's compassion is a metaphor for God's total involvement with life. It's an image of life, participating in life, coming together as one in relationship. And it's in the lived encounter with suffering and pain that hope emerges. Well, alongside the freedom and vulnerability of God stands the fidelity of God. God's love and the offer of that relationship is permanent and unconditional. We are the people of God. And the hope that we speak of is connected to our freedom to witness with good news about justice and equality, especially for those who are held in captivity by the marks of the empire. And Christian hope is not shallow. It's not sentimental. It's the fruit of the desperate reality of the cross and the glorious reality of the resurrection. It's born in our heavy ears to hear the gospel message of the reign of God, which Jesus preached, eyes to see and believe that we can become witnesses of the reign by what we say and what we do. Well, hope is made visible when we are rooted in our understanding of what it means to be a people of God. But hope is also made visible when we engage in a time of truth-telling and truth-facing. We can't become instruments of hope without taking the time to engage in self-examination. The truth is that the marks of the empire are not simply realities that are out there. The empire has also taken up residency in us. The pandemics caused an unearthing and revealing of who we are, what we believe, what we see, who we are serving, and who we are not. Pandemics, as the old folk used to say, has created our own come to Jesus moment. The truth is, we have not overcome yet. We are still a people under construction. We are still trying to find the path that will lead from fragmentation to wholeness, from slavery to freedom, from privilege and power to equality and opportunity for all, from white supremacy to the beloved community, from oppression and internalized oppression to justice and dignity and respect. We have to confess, we're still seeking the path from the despair of our past and our present to the promise and hope of our future. Well, as we leave this meeting, amnesia is not an option. Gladys Knight, in the lines of one of her songs, declares, "What is too painful to remember? We simply choose to forget." Well, this is our time for remembering, and in remembering, to tell the truth and face the truth. Roberta Flack talks about what change can mean in one of her songs. Roberta Flack, in one of her songs, said, "I told Jesus it would be all right if he changed my name. And he told me, child, look, the world will turn away from you if I change your name. Your mother and father won't even recognize you if I change your name." But Roberta said, "I still told Jesus that it would be all right if he changed my name." Truth telling and truth facing calls us back from the temptation to get lost in private definitions. It's a way of calling us back from existences where we lose our grounding in community or our sense of collective responsibility for our neighbor. The hope that we speak of is made visible when we can face the truth of the marks of the empire that holds our minds, our bodies, our souls, and our ministries in captivity. Hope is made visible as we name and unmask and dismantle racism in all aspects of our health and human services. It's a requirement if we are to witness to the world that God intends. But finally, hope is made visible as we invest our resources with clarity, with courage, and with conviction for justice. This requires specific goals and objectives that create equity for those who are displaced and disempowered and under-resourced and underserved. It's what we do when we are bound in hope. The gospel makes a demand. It's about how God works in the person of Jesus Christ for liberation from every bondage. And God's Spirit will use us as her instrument only as we remain agents of liberation by using our resources to usher in the beloved community. A community filled up by the pillars of love and justice made visible. Hope becomes visible as we invest our resources in times of despair. Pandemics, yes, they are times of chaos, but they are also times of opportunity. It's precisely in the midst of despair that seeds and possibilities of hope are born. It's in difficult times that we are called to speak and act with prophetic courage and clarity and conviction. I'm the descendants of those mamas and daddies who experienced whips and chains, slave ships and auction blocks, plantations, the Klan, the lynchings, the separate but equal, bus boycotts and picket lines of hoses and veils. And I've been nurtured by a spirituality that was born in the context of the struggle for justice. It was in the midst of difficult days and hard times that we sang our songs. We sang our songs on boats called Jesus that brought us to America. We sang our songs on auction blocks. Over my head, I hear music in the air. There must be a God somewhere. We sang our songs on plantation. Walk together, children, and don't you get weary, because there's a camp meeting in the promised land. We sang our songs on picket line. Ain't gonna let nobody turn me around now. I'm gonna keep on marching and praying and witnessing and singing and moving for freedom in the land. We sang our songs and we invested our resources by creating churches and educational institutions and banks and insurance and burial societies and camps and conferences and retreat centers. In the midst of difficult times, we invested our resources and we invested them in our sons and in our daughters. We brought them to places like Franklinton Center at Bridge where they could become strong. I stand as a witness, having been nurtured and equipped as a young person at Franklinton Center at Bridge, a place that used to be a slave plantation, transformed into being a place of wholeness and healness, wholeness and justice, empowerment for justice. And it is now one of the ministry settings affiliated with Chisholm. Hope. Well, as one of the concluding words, this is one of the concluding words, I want to send you forth with Paul's words of inspiration and encouragement to the early church. Go out. The powers and principalities are real. Go out. Injustice is real, but go out. Having to stand up and witness strong for what you believe in, go out and go out, not just with a little bit of hope, but go out with abounding hope, etched in a belief that beyond every crucifixion, there is the possibility of a resurrection. Go out prepared to serve, believing that the gospel makes a demand. We're not captive to the old order. We're not the surrogates of the empire. We are not defined by imperial definitions of reality. We are not authored by the law. Our credentials do not come from achievements. Rather, we are offered by a voice from eternity that calls us by name. The Holy One tells us we are authored by a network of meanings and covenants and relationships. We don't belong to the gods of the empire, the gods of nationalism or racism, classism, sexism. And hope, well, it's made visible with our words and with our actions. Invisibility is not an option. Silence is not an option. So go out in the name of the God of justice and freedom and liberation. Go out in the holy power and authority of God. We have seen her face through every trial and every tribulation. We know her to be the Alpha and the Omega, our bridge over troubled waters, the one who just keeps on making a way out of no way. So with God firmly at our center, let's get ready to run on and work on to see what the end is be as we run with God. God is life and love. God is the one who is able to make crooked roads straight and the rough places plain. God is the spirit that just moves in us, making a way out of what we think is no way. God is the heart fixer and the mind regulator. God is that eternal spirit that just keeps on renewing our strength so that we can mount up with wings like eagles. We can run and not be weary. Well, if this God is for us, we are more than conquerors over all the forces that would seek to prevail against us. And if we're faithful, eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, just what God can do in us and through us. So it's time to leave our virtual time of this annual meeting and to move powerfully together in hope. So it's my prayer that our God of hope will fill us with abundance of hope, so that we can become powerful instruments of hope. And it's done by the power of the Holy Spirit. Let us go forward ready to witness. The world needs it. Amen.
I believe in love. Please join us for this call and response prayer. I will read the one and you all will join for the all. How good it is to center down, to sit quietly and see oneself pass by the streets of our minds seethe with endless traffic.
Our spirits resound with clashings, with noisy silences.
While something deep within hungers and thirsts for the still moment and the resting lull. With full intensity, we seek a fresh sense of order in our living.
A direction, a strong, sure purpose that will structure our confusion and bring meaning into our chaos.
We look at ourselves in this waiting moment, the kinds of people we are, the questions persist. What are we doing with our lives?
What are the motives that order our days? What is the end of our doings? Where are we trying to go?
Where do we put the emphasis and where are our values focused? For what end do we make sacrifices?
Where is my treasure and what do I love most in life? What do I hate most in life? And to what am I true?
Over and over, the questions beat upon the waiting moment. As we listen, floating up through all the jangling echoes of our turbulence, there is a sound of another kind.
A deeper note, which only the stillness of the heart makes clear.
It moves directly to the core of our being. Our questions are answered, our spirits refreshed.
And we move back into the traffic of our daily round with the peace of the eternal in our step.
Oh, how good it is to center down.
How good it is to center down. Amen.
I invite you now into a spirit of prayer as we prepare our hearts for the benediction. Let us pray. Beloveds, we have claimed our place in the ecosystem of the Spirit, alive, connected, and emergent with grace. Let us go forth from this fertile ground, ripening the wisdom we found through justice and compassion. And so, may the blessing of our communal Creator replenish you today and always. And the people of God said, Amen.
We stand with love. Just sit in this place alone. much is wrong. But is there anything we can do? Where is the hope? When there is so much pain, so much is broken, can it be whole again? We can just sit in this place and long for better days. We can just sit in this place alone.
Hi, I'm Abby Drain, Chair of the Council on Health and Human Services Board. On behalf of the board and staff, I want to thank you for attending our conference this year. Thank you to our sponsors, our annual gathering task force, and everyone who worked to make this conference such an inspiring event. We hope you feel uplifted and more confident that together in hope, we can realize our vision of a just, caring, and compassionate world. We hope to see you in person at next year's annual gathering, which will be March 7th through 9th, 2022 in Louisville, Kentucky, the place I call home. We look forward to welcoming you there. Blessings and peace till we meet again.